everybody, it's PK, and welcome to week 5 of Freedom Culture. We are learning all about your story this month, God's purpose for you on this earth and what he did to set us free from sin. We've been learning a lot about sin and the gift of salvation in the past few weeks. And tonight, we are going to be focusing on what we need to do to receive that gift of salvation. So, let's go ahead and get started. Let's open up with a word of prayer. Hope you are ready to go. It's going to be awesome. Dear Heavenly Father, we thank you for this day. Thank you for all these boys and girls who are tuning in, who are pressing in, who are trying to hear their Heavenly Father's voice and know their Heavenly Father in a deeper way. I pray that you bless them, Father, and that the words of these lessons tonight take root deep in their heart, Lord, and bloom and blossom into something really amazing for your kingdom. We love you, Lord. In Jesus' name, amen. All right, next up, we have object lesson with yours truly. We'll see you there. Hi, everybody. It's Pastor Katie, and in tonight's lesson, we are learning all about, in your story, believing, turning to God, and receiving the gift that he has for us. Now, as you can see, I have a few gifts here that I'm holding on to pretty tightly, and these are things that we walk around with a lot in our lives, and we hold on to really tightly. As you can see, I have guilt here, and here I have pride. Now, a lot of us carry these things in our heart before we turn to God. We carry around guilt because we're not perfect and we mess up, and then we carry around pride as well. And pride is really us wanting to do things our own way. We can't surrender to God's way. We don't want to do it his way. We don't want to try it his way. And so we are determined that we're going to make it our own way. And the truth is, we all fall short. We know that we can't do it on our own. We know that our way leads to hell. And so we don't want to do it our way, right? So the thing is, God, we learned last week, he has given us a free gift of salvation. He sent his son to die for us on the cross so that we could be saved. And we have to believe, right? We have to believe in Jesus and what he did for us and accept that gift of salvation. But as you can see, when I'm carrying around these things, guilt and pride, my hands are tied up. See, I don't have an extra hand to carry that gift of salvation. I can't carry guilt and I can't carry pride. I can't do things my own way and keep living in guilt for my sins and receive salvation at the same time. So this is what's really cool. God calls us to trade with him, right? So I want to read our memory verse for today, and it's found in Acts 16, verse 31. They replied, "Believe in the Lord Jesus and you will be saved, you and your household." I'm going to read that again. They replied, "Believe in the Lord Jesus and you will be saved, you and your household." See, whenever we decide to believe in Jesus, we realize that it's okay that we aren't perfect. It's okay. It's okay because Jesus redeems us through the gift of his blood. So we don't have to carry on guilt anymore. We don't have to hold that guilt anymore. See, I have one hand freed up. And we also realize that we can't do it on our own, that we need a savior. And so we're like, you know what? I don't have to do things my own way anymore. I'm going to give that up too. I'm going to believe in Jesus, that I don't need to do things my own way, that I can trust in him, that I don't need to hold on to shame any longer or guilt because of my sins, because I believe that Jesus can wash me clean of my sins, that he can forgive me, that his sacrifice on the cross was big enough, great enough to redeem me from my sin. And I'm going to accept this beautiful gift of salvation. So that's what I want to challenge you guys to do tonight, is surrender whatever you're dealing with, whether it's guilt, shame, pride, doing things your own way, give those to Jesus and accept his gift, his way, his salvation, the free gift to us. I love you guys. Next up, we have worship.
I've been asleep head in the sand, watching the time just ticking. Clock runs around, days in and out, can't really call it living. Somewhere I let light go dark, but here's where my new story starts. Take my life and let it be, set on fire for all to see. Break me down, build me up again, don't leave me the way I've been. Take my heart into your hands, come and finish while you begin. Till I seek your kingdom first, till I shine, shine like heaven on earth. Like heaven on earth. I wanna be part of what you're doing. In my heart, let kingdom come. Not my will, but yours be done. Take my life and let it be, set on fire for all to see. Break me down, build me up again, don't leave me the way I've been. Take my heart into your hands, come and finish while you begin. Till I seek your kingdom first, like heaven on earth. Help me move when I should move, help me rest when I should rest, help me give what I should give, all of me, nothing less. Help me speak with grace and truth, help me fight for those who came, help me love the way you love.
That I am now a friend of God. even at my loneliest, there's no greater love than this. You took the nails to hold me close. If I said thank you a million times, it's not enough. But I'll sing praises for all my life, 'cause I'm in cross. The Father loved the soul so much that when we did our very worst, Jesus gave his very best, and he died for all of us.
Guys, it's Eman, and I am excited to be teaching you the second part of the message about salvation. Last week, we kind of had this question of what should our response be to the gospel, because we said that just because Jesus died on the cross for all sinners, it doesn't mean that everyone's automatically saved, that there should be a response. And so last week, we said that one of the things that Jesus says was to repent. And we said repentance is a change of heart. It's coming to our senses, knowing we're guilty before God in our fallen state as sinners, and that we can't make it on our own. We can't do anything perfectly to be able to be accepted by God. And so we said that we showed that a great example of repentance was the prodigal son. And so this week we're going to focus on the second part of our response, and that's what Jesus said was to believe in the gospel. And so we're going to look at, what does it mean to believe in the gospel? What should we as Christians believe? It's a little windy out here today, so just bear with me here. The camera might shake like it is now. But there's three main points to this that I want to teach. And the first thing is that we believe in the truth. Okay? What is the truth? It is the word of God. Jesus says, prays over his disciples, and he says, sanctify them, Father, by your truth, or set them apart from the world by your truth. Your word is truth. Okay, so it's the Bible from cover to cover. And we, as Christians, we should believe in the entirety of the Bible, the whole thing. Okay, and the main point about the gospel is that main point about the Bible, God's word, is that, you know, so everything we've been talking about, that God created man rejected God, and we deserve death for that, but God provided a way for us to be saved through Jesus. Okay, and so that leads me to my second point, and that is we should believe in Jesus as our personal Savior. Okay, in Romans chapter 10 verse 9, it says, if you confess with your mouth that Jesus is Lord and believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead, you will be saved. And so it is a personal thing. It's a personal choice and decision for you and me to make. And that is whether we want to have Jesus in our life as our Lord and our Savior, that we believe what he did on the cross, or we don't. And there's really two parts to this. This is when we come to Jesus and want to become a Christian, because we believe in who Jesus is, okay, that he is Lord. And what does that mean? It means that he is God. Okay, and we're going to talk about lordship more in the next few weeks, but for this purpose, in this context of this verse and this teaching, Lord means that Jesus is God. He is the Son of God. He comes from God. He's the only one that has ever come from God, and he came to save us. And so the second part of that is that we believe in what he's done. Okay, Jesus willingly laid his life down for us, that to die on the cross, okay, bearing the sins of the world. He who knew no sin became sin on our behalf, is what Miss Jean, that verse that Miss Jean talked about a couple weeks ago, and died on the cross, was buried, and rose again. And so we as Christians should believe that. And we receive the gift of salvation, this gift of grace that God gives us. And the third thing, the third main point, is that we as Christians, it's part of our faith, is that we love and obey God. Okay, it's important that we not just say that we believe in Jesus, but that our life shows that we believe. Right? It's evidence that we really are a child of God. We really do love God. And so, you know, when we think about obeying, we might think that it's about following rules, a list of rules, and do this and don't do that, but that shouldn't be our focus, okay? Our focus should be loving God and loving others, and when we do that, our life will show that we love God and love others. We will do good works and do good things, and stay away from doing bad things. And you know, Jesus knew that man couldn't keep a perfect list of rules and laws, right? And he said, you know, if you love me, you will keep my commandments. Okay, he didn't say, if you keep my commandments, that's how I know you'll love me. No, it starts with our love for God. And when we love someone, we will obey them. And in the next verse, in John, he says, right after that, he says, and I will pray to the Father to give you another helper to be with you forever. And so Jesus knew, I mean, God knows that we're not perfect. So he gives us a helper, the Holy Spirit, who helps us live a godly life. So we're not on our own in doing that. But obedience starts with love, okay? And that's what I want you guys to, I call on you guys to do. If you have never done this before, to repent of your sins, believe, turn to God, turn to Jesus, and believe in the gospel. And you know, when we do that, okay, when we do that, we're going to talk about this more, is we become reborn. This is something that Jesus was trying to explain to Nicodemus, who came to him in the middle of the night asking him about the kingdom of God. And Jesus says, unless you're born again, you can't enter. And so when that being born again starts with repentance and faith, repentance and believing in God, and then we become reborn, we can become changed with a new heart, become a new creature in Christ. And we're led by his Holy Spirit to live a godly life. So guys, I want to leave you with that. But before I do, let's close out in prayer. Heavenly Father, thank you for this day. God, we thank you for your mercy and your grace, God. We thank you for this message of salvation, for repentance and believing and turning to you. And God, I just pray over everyone who's watching, Lord, whether child or adult too, that they've never repented believed in you, Lord, as their Savior. God, I pray that you'd work that in their heart. Lord, convict them of any sin, and Lord, that they would open their heart to you. Lord, you would change their heart, and Lord, that you would bring faith in their heart, Lord, that they would believe and love you and obey you, Lord. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' name, we give you the glory. Amen. Guys, thank you so much for being with us, and I love you guys. Seeing you real soon. Bye.
The question. Yay!
All right, everybody. everybody. That was a fantastic night. We had a great lesson, great worship, a fun object lesson. And I pray tonight that you feel encouraged, that you feel that you can finally let go of whatever you're holding on to and give those things to Jesus and accept this beautiful free gift that he has for you, because he is waiting for you. He created you to live a life with him. He created you to do amazing things here on this earth. And you can only experience the true greatness of God if you're willing to accept his gift of salvation and do things his way and surrender your ways, because our ways, we know, are going to get us into a mess, right? So we don't want to do things our own way. We want to do things God's way, the right way. I love you, boys and girls, and we will see you next week for week 6 of Freedom Culture. Bye.